Hello and welcome back, my beautiful froggy army, to another video. We're gonna start off this video with a bang. I have a problem. I have a dilemma and I don't know what to do. Okay, so basically, as you may or may not know, here on the channel, I've been looking for stitches for quite some time. Actually, not a long time. I did like two hunts, but I've spent over 200 tickets looking for him and he has not shown up. I have not seen that boy. And I still have this open plot. I have been time traveling to make sure it stays open, and it seems like everything would be fine, right? Like I will just keep time traveling and keep looking for him. But no, I have been procrastinating building my candy shop for Leapfrog that I have been planning for a while now as well. So I've been wanting to put it right here, like in this like little rectangular area, right, all around here. But do you see the issue? There is a house right where I want to put the candy shop. At least this is where a top corner of it is gonna go. I need to move this house. But how do you move a house? You have to time travel. And if I time travel, I'm going to autofill that plot. There's a good chance it could be stitches. Like, don't get me wrong. We could just autofill stitches and that would be so awesome. But there's also a chance it could be just a random villager that I don't want and I'm gonna be upset about it. So I don't really know what to do. I've had all the items, or some of the items for the candy shop, just like chilling here, and I don't want them to sit here anymore. And I just can't keep procrastinating this candy shop. And I can't just do straight villager hunting videos back to back. Like, I need to work on builds. I need to work on my island. I haven't made any progress for what feels like a long time. I just really need this build right now, okay? So yeah, that's kind of my dilemma right now. And I'm explaining this all to you because I do think that I have to autofill the plot. I know I have said things in the past, like, I am not going to just take any random villager, I'm going to stay strong for stitches. However, I think desperate times call for desperate measures. Sometimes things don't go as we plan, especially when you are me and you don't plan your content in advance. So with all that being said, I think I'm going to go ahead and move the house. I don't even know whose house that is. I think it's Jeremiah's. Let me double check. It is indeed Jeremiah's. And as you can see, we have like this little rectangle shape-ish. Well, the side of it, that little corner is rounded, but that little area is going to be so perfect for my candy shop. I really, really want to put it right there. I just feel like it's going to be the best. Yeah, this is something that I have to do. It sucks. It sucks because I know I'm just going to get a rando villager and I'm going to have just another rando villager to kick out, but I don't know. I guess it means more hunts in the future, which is great. But yeah, I'm just gonna go and do what needs to be done. It really sucks because I was so motivated. I was so dedicated to stitches and keeping this plot open for him and just getting him. I didn't want to take anybody else. I didn't want to have to deal with other villagers. I just wanted stitches or Scoot or Henry, but like I said, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Not everything works out the way you plan it, and that's just the reality of life. And that's what we're dealing with today. Real life struggles, problems. But you know what? Jeremiah comes in and I just see his adorable little blue face and I just feel so much better about myself. So I'm gonna stop being sad about it. All right, so where I'm going to move Jeremiah's house is gonna be all the way in the back of my island somewhere. I don't really know the exact spots. My island is still mostly flat except for the front entrance area. But yeah, the back half of my island is gonna be like the frog area of Leapfrog. Here we go. I don't know. We'll deal with that later. I'm not gonna worry about his house right now or decorating his yard or anything. Oh, you can jump this? Sick. Parkour. And we're gonna time travel to tomorrow and see what our luck is like. Who knows? Maybe it's stitches. But I highly doubt it. But anyways, let's just go. Okay, so I'm pretty much going into this. Ooh, a book. Nice. Flick, you better give me some good luck. I'm just hoping that it's just like Scoot or something. I don't know. So I could just be happy. But yeah, I'm just putting my expectations on the floor. And I just know it's going to be some rando who I don't really want right now that I'm going to have to kick out eventually. And it's fine. Vivian. Okay. I'm not mad about Vivian. Vivian is cute, but like I said, just kind of a rando. But it's fine. It's fine. I'm not upset. But we did accomplish what we needed to get done, which was to open this space up. Now we have space for our candy shop to go all in this area, and that is going to be the next video that I put out, so that's going to be real exciting. So keep an eye out for that coming out very soon to a theater near you. But in the meantime, I guess let's try to figure out whose item this is. I used to just keep these on my old island because I would use them to decorate, but I don't think I'm gonna use them on this island. Egbert has been having a lot of weird dreams lately. In my dreams, we talked every night. Sometimes you had two heads. So I'm betting that right now is real. What the heck? Why is Egbert so weird to me? Okay, even if this is your book, I'm not giving it back. Oh, poor Willow. I'm so sorry. Oh my god, Egbert. Okay. Anyways, Willow, is this your book? Aw, Cousteau? Okay. We'll go give it to our little cheese frog boy. Pretty sure this is yours. You had my workout journal. I can't leave you empty-handed. Here's a little thank you gift. Clothes. It's always clothes. Okay, so I have come in my house, ignore the state of it, to grab some items because I have had an idea for how to decorate the outside of my house. I will link the video if you haven't seen it already, but I did create like a whole yard area, house area. I've just put my house down and I decided on the spot for it. So now I just have to decorate and I didn't have any ideas of what to do, but I think I have figured it out and I'm really excited about it. I don't know if I'll be able to make it work like how I envisioned it in my head, but we're gonna try. So basically, you know, to preface this idea, and I know I'm giving a long-winded explanation to this, but just hear me out. So basically, the kidcore aesthetic to me and to a lot of people involves a lot of nostalgia, you know, things that we grew up with, things that we did as a kid, toys that we played with as a kid, stuff like that. And a really big part of my childhood, oddly enough, and this might sound weird, it might not be a universal experience, but I would go to a lot of garage sales or yard sales with my family when I was a kid. Mostly, you know, my mom because my dad would be at work, but my mom would take me and my siblings and we would go to yard sales. And we didn't have a lot of money, so it was a good way for us to get stuff, whatever. And we were also kids, so kids grow out of clothes a lot. So a good way to get, you know, clothes cheap when kids are just growing out of clothes left and right is to get them used or secondhand or whatever. And I have a lot of memories of just spending hours on weekends going to yard sales, you know, driving around random neighborhoods, going up to people's yards and just like looking at their stuff, rifling through the little toys. And yeah, it was a big part of my childhood and I don't know if that's random or whatever, but it is what it is. So I'm just basically like grabbing random stuff right now to try to, I don't know, mimic the randomness of garage sales or yard sales. And I need some sort of like folding table or something. I might have to order that. Ooh, it is so dark out here. I might have to time travel a day. I am hoping that I can find a yard sale sign because otherwise this will just look like a pile of random clutter and it's not going to be what I'm going for. So let's see if we can find anything. I think so. I'm pretty sure there has to be something. Oh heck yeah. There's 5 whole pages of this. Okay, perfect. So this is like the typical one that I would always see. Like people would stick these in the ground at like intersections and stuff. I'm crying at this. Lasardia. 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 I think I'm actually gonna go with this one. I don't know why, but it's speaking to me. I could always change it later if I don't end up liking it, but yeah, we're gonna go ahead and save this one. Okay, so I grabbed items and made the little sign and everything, but I need a couple more things, so I'm gonna order some stuff, time travel to tomorrow, and also hopefully get rid of this rain. It's a little dreary, so yeah, I will see you tomorrow. And I am reminded of my mistakes. Okay, so we did not get rid of the rain, but that's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my items and stuff and we can get to work. Okay, so obviously we don't have a lot of space to work with here. Yeah, not much at all. And I kind of give up on making like my house cute anyways. Like, I don't know how to do that. So I'm fine with just having this be like a cluttered, chaotic mess. I'm okay with it. And this might not even come out good, and that's also fine since this is gonna go right next to this little stream. I'm gonna put a puddle and I want to just scooch this over on top of this puddle. Cute. Okay. So what I do need to be happening here is a clear path to this bridge. At least two tiles of clear path, because I will not have myself stepping over stuff to get out. I refuse to do it. So we're gonna make sure that we leave that clear. I'm sure it won't be that much of a problem. I feel like we're also gonna need some sort of like trees, plants, something. Because I'm not gonna put the yard sale like all the way back here in the back. I probably won't keep this either. And I'm probably not gonna put yard sale stuff back here. So that can be like free reign for whatever. I don't know what I'm even gonna fit. We have so little space, but whatever, we'll figure it out. So we basically just have like this whole territory to work with. And honestly, this is not as much space as I thought it was gonna be. So basically, whenever I would go to yard sales, they would always have like their garage open. And they would have clothes like hanging in their garage or like on a little clothes hanger rack like right in front of the garage. So I do want to put some sort of like clothes right here. Maybe either like a table with like clothes on top of it, or maybe just like a clothesline, just to, I don't know, that's the closest thing I can think of. So that's what I want to put like right here. And then there's always like tables, like folding tables, just with like stuff on it. So I didn't really like the look of the only folding table that I had. And I know this isn't very like garage core, like yard sale core, but I don't know. I'm just gonna try to use these den desks, I guess. I don't know. I kind of want to actually order the other ones. Now that I'm putting these down, I don't like it. So this is what I was talking about. And as you can see, like the edges of it are black, which I don't like to use like a black furniture for kid core. But I did find out that you can customize this and make it a different color, at least the white part. When I was googling if there's like other color variations. So I think we will order these and just make do. I know this is a lot of like time traveling and like ordering stuff, but this is like in reality how these builds go. This is just my process. So I'm gonna do this like little grocery design just to give it that like more cluttered look when we put stuff on top of it. All right, so let's get rid of this, or not. Let's get rid of this. And let's toss some custom designs underneath first. You gotta. Maybe some pictures fell on the ground and maybe someone dropped their little snack. I want to put some fences. So we are going to, of course, put some custom designs first underneath because I legally have to. Just want to have like a nice little perimeter of fences. Nothing too crazy. Just some here and there. Okay, so something like that, you know, just give it a little border. I think that looks great. I can already see that we're gonna need to have like a one tile path at least right here. So let me mark that out just with some custom designs. That way I know my limits. Okay, so I guess this should be the toy section. I'm liking the toy section being over here. So maybe we have like a toy box right here full of toys. Nice and green. Ooh, that literally like matches my house. Like the green of the box and the yellow of the giraffe. How cute is that? And then maybe we have something else random here, like a football. Yeah, sports. And then definitely a box right here. There's definitely gonna be lots of cardboard boxes everywhere because stuff is also just like in boxes everywhere. Just like maybe this is a box of books. I was a huge bookworm as a kid, so that's what I would always gravitate to. Like whenever we went to yard sales, I would always go straight for the box of books, and I would look for the kids books or like whatever young adult novels and find like, you know, the Warrior Cats books and all of that stuff. I actually didn't read Warrior Cats, but you know, stuff like that. You know what I'm talking about. This is actually like just this little section is already giving me the yard sale vibes that I was perfectly envisioning. So I'm super happy about that. Yeah, I guess let's just put more custom designs. We can have some little Polaroids on the ground right here. Maybe someone is playing with a toy right here, like a board game. Cause that's also something that I would do. And like my siblings, we would just like start playing with the toys like there, and it was always so awkward. But I mean, we were just kids, so I guess the people running the yard sale didn't really mind. I do kind of want to give my little house area some sort of like driveway or something, I don't know, but I'm just gonna start trying to do something right here and hoping it works, crossing my fingers. Yeah, that's kind of what I was envisioning. That's gonna be good enough. And then let's put some sort of tile. I don't really know what to put. Maybe the froggy tile. I wanted to match my house, but I don't know. I might change my house in the future, like the color. Let's just put the froggy tiles, I guess. And we pretend we do not see the stone underneath. It does not exist. It is not there. What are you talking about? So here is like the little clothes that people are selling. Or I guess I'm selling in this case. Am I the one selling this stuff? We're severely lacking in custom designs right here though, so I gotta fix that. Okay, I'm kind of veering off of the little yard sale part right now, but okay, this is gonna be like my little backyard area, and I don't know what I'm gonna do here, but we will figure it out. Okay, so I'm just gonna have like this short little path, and I want to put some hedges like right on top of this puddle and right here, I think. Okay, so I forgot to unpause the recording. I don't know where I stopped recording, but yeah, this is where we're at. Okay, so since this is the little clothes section, I'm gonna put down like some clothing items. No, I don't want to wear them. No. Oh, interesting. They made a different noise. That was weird. But we're gonna put down some little shoes, and I'm gonna put down some socks, and these are all gonna be like clothes. Okay, so yeah, like that. That is looking good. Okay, and then I think I want to move my mailbox somewhere else. I don't know if it's gonna be like somewhere else here or somewhere else entirely, but I really want this little section right here to be for a table. And before we work on this, let me take this down because I don't think that's gonna be permanent. And let me do the same thing that I did on the other side, but on this side, which is use my little hedgies and make kind of like a little opening. And then I do want to do a little bit more of my regular old iron fencing. I think I'm just going to do it like right here. I'm scared if I do it along this edge, like if I could do it right here, but I feel like that's kind of weird, like right next to the hedges like that. And yeah, I'm not a big fan. So we're gonna leave this naked. But maybe we can do right here. We can make like a little corner like that. So I don't know. We'll see how I feel about that. I also will probably put fencing like back here just so it looks more cohesive. I'll just do that super quick just so, I don't know, it doesn't look so weird. So something like that basically. I think that looks a little more put together, like an actual like fenced in yard. And I guess I'm just gonna fill up this table with like random stuff. There's like a little phone, maybe some little jewelry, accessories. I don't know what else to put. I just kind of grabbed random stuff. So ant farm, very curious. And we can put like a book. Yeah, just a straight up book. Let's see, we have some room to add some extra random stuff that's a little bit taller. We have this like iron hanger stand, which I think would be good in the clothing section. Let's see if I can find a spot for it. It could go right here. It's kind of an awkward area though. Oh no, that's actually not that bad. I don't know why this has a juice box on it, but we will roll with it, honestly. Then I also have this guitar, which I think is a perfect garage sale item. So I'm gonna scooch this over as far as it'll go. That's perfect. That's actually perfect right there. So it's coming together. I really like the look of this. I love the clutteredness. Just like the folding tables and just the stuff everywhere just gives me so much nostalgia and memories. I'm also gonna add this little hopscotch because surely there were some kids that started messing with like chalk or something and made up this little like hopscotch thing. So I'm gonna add that. Gonna see, does a plasma ball fit here? It kind of does. Okay, I'm gonna put the plasma ball there. Let's add a little dirt spot. And you know, there was always, for sure, kids riding around in like scooters and bicycles and all kinds of stuff like that. That was, you know, trying to be sold at the yard sale, but they just would just start riding it. So I'm gonna add this little scooter, and I think I have a tricycle I also want to put somewhere, but I'm kind of running out of room here. Oh, it fits right in here. So as you can see, we're kind of filling up like these little corners and just leaving like this like V-shaped path for me to go in, which works. It works. I mean, I'm not gonna be like going through here a lot probably. I'm probably just gonna be going from my door outwards, so that is perfectly fine with me. Gonna see if this piano bench fits here. This is just like a random piano bench that I have that I don't really like the color of, so we're just gonna shove it here. and stick something on top of it. Definitely a teddy bear is a must-needed item. That's another item that I would always go for, like the plushies. Oh yes, it all started as a child, my obsession. Another fond memory I have of yard sales is always getting food at them. They would grill hamburgers and hot dogs or sell like brownies and stuff. And mostly I just remember like lemonade and sodas. But I wanted to mimic that here with like a little table and like some drinks. I don't really have anything else besides like tea, so I'm just gonna put the tea cozy and that's just gonna have to do. I think the infused like water dispenser would be perfect, but I don't have that DIY here and I'm too lazy to go on my other island and get it, so yeah, that's what we're gonna do. And I have decided that I do not like the juice box any longer, so I'm gonna go customize that. Okay, so now I want to figure out a tall item to put right here. Like I was saying, ignore Pepper if you can hear him. We could do a very festive balloon. Ooh, I like that. I mean, it's very tall. Yeah, I think I like the balloon. We're gonna go with that. And then to keep tying in the whole like snack thing that I was talking about earlier, I'm gonna put this popcorn machine because I feel like that's something that people would have sometimes as well, like popcorn and like chips and stuff. So I'm gonna put that there. Now I just feel like we need some more custom designs like here and there just to spice it up a teensy tiny bit, and then we're like good to go. So I'm gonna add my little Polaroids. I'm gonna probably stick a froggy right here. Probably get rid of this little ducky and maybe add some little dirt spots here and there just so something like shows up on my map for once, you know? And you know what's always a good addition? Puddles. Puddles just go great everywhere. I literally think you can do no wrong with them. There is no wrong spot for them whatsoever. And now these spaces that like don't have a custom design feel kind of naked, but like I don't want to cover just absolutely everything in custom designs. I feel like that's overkill, but at the same time, you know? Oh, you know what we can do? We can do like weeds or planting something in the ground. Oh, let's do some little coconuts. Let me go grab some coconuts. So life hack, if you didn't know this, you can just plant coconuts into grass and they will stay as these little sprouts, and they're so cute. I love them so much. I use them all the time and they are just simply perfect. So I still don't know what I'm going to do in these little back sections. Like I have this section back here, and on the other side I also have just a little section where we can add more things. I want that to be something that I think of at a later time. I don't want to just put something random there right now just to destroy it later. So once I have an idea, I'll definitely, you know, actually put it there. But for now, we're going to leave it empty. Hopefully I will add some trees back here so we have like a little more vertical height and it's not just kind of like all on the floor. But that is going to be something for future me. I really like how this came out. This is my childhood in a nutshell, so even if it's not for you, this makes me so happy and brings back a lot of memories. So yeah, I'm just very, very happy with it, and I'm excited that I'm gonna get to see this every single time I walk out of my house. It's just gonna be great. Oh, I forgot a little custom design here. There has to be something here. I'm gonna put some little candies. Okay, yes, much better. So that's going to be it for me today, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed the video with our villager struggles and also doing this. I really enjoyed building this little like yard sale yard for my house. It was so much fun and I hope you had fun with me. If you did have fun, I would really appreciate it if you could hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Very highly recommended, 10 out of 10 decision. If you like content just like this, I post it every Wednesday and Saturday at 2 p.m. EST. And if not, you can still catch me on my social medias, which will all be linked down below in the description. Thank you once again for watching. I really appreciate it. And bonus points if you actually listen to what I say at the end of my videos. I really appreciate those of you who do. Stay safe out there. I hope you have a lot of fun in Animal Crossing or doing whatever it is to bring you some joy today. And I will see you in the next one.